Hello guys and welcome back. In this video I wanted to talk about the packed primitives and how it works. And so I have this statue here which has 500 points, and I'm going to duplicate this 500,000, sorry. I'm going to duplicate this four times and move them apart. And once we do that, we're going to get 2 million points. But they're all the same geometry. They're all these guys just being copied and moved over. And in reality, we don't have to duplicate this unless we're planning to deform these guys individually. We can create what we call an instance, basically. This is similar to rendering instancing, render instancing in at render time. You generate the main copy, the main source, and then that gets copied multiple times. Same thing here, SideFX came up with this concept called packed primitives, where you can take a huge amount of data and then pack it into basically a point. This is going to be represented by a point. And then all these guys, instead of being duplicates, they can just reference this main guy. So let's say we have a huge block of data. This is 1 million points. And this is something very common in programming. 1 million points. When you have this much data and you wanted to access it in for eaches or in multiple places, you don't duplicate the data if you're not planning on changing it. If you want, for example, to take this data and rotate it or move it or transform it or display it in a different way, you don't have to duplicate the data. You can just take it as it is and post-process it here, so you don't end up duplicating this. And this is what packed primitives is. All these guys are basically streaming in data from here. Now, what's the advantage of this? Well, the advantage of this is we can, it's not just doing it for the memory. It's also doing what we call a GPU cache. So all these points will get cached into the GPU, and every time we reference it, the GPU is not going to generate a new cache. It's going to stream those points directly and display them. And this is very, very powerful because we can have unlimited amount of a huge amount of copies, and it will be super, super fast to display, because displaying the triangles is not hard on the GPU. It's the data and streaming that. So here you can see there is this packet instance. I'm going to change the number, and you guys, I'm going to change it to 10, and you will see how much it takes. It's freezing now. The machine is freezing. And there we go. It took 2.06 seconds to compute, and now we have this. If we turn on packed, now it's going to be much, much lighter to work with. And I can change this. Let's go back. I'll explain why is that. So if I change this, you can see how fast it is. I can even make copies of this and change it like that. Now, the reason it's not displaying this is because there is a limit. You see, as I zoom in, it's only displaying certain portion. And the control for that is trying to limit the polygon display. But first of all, I'm going to turn on the FPS, so we can do that under guide, show time, and that will show the FPS. We're at 40, and let's turn on always the geo count. You can see it's displaying 11 points. It's not displaying 10 million or anything. So let's control this. If we go under optimize, I think no. Let's see where it is. Subdivision limit. Yeah, this distance packed geometry calling, we can turn this off completely and it will display all everything in the viewport. And this is really fast compared to if we had a lot of individual geometry. And this is 11 copies. So we have about 124 copies multiplied by 500. And this is all displayed in the viewport. Now, this is not the only advantage for packed primitives. Now that we have these guys as individual points, we don't have to worry about manipulating all the points. We can just treat them as points, basically, and we can, let's say, let's add a jitter here. You can see we're adding a jitter, and this works on point level. It's not, it doesn't work specifically on packed primitives. You can see they're being treated as points, and this is great because we can deal with we can work with geometry better if we have points. And I'm going to show an example for where this is going to come in handy. So I'll continue in the next video. Thank you for watching, and see you in a bit.